Students, we are in chapter 7, that is working with open office calc. So in the previous class we have completed the introduction that are related to open office calc. Okay, wow. So clear with the introduction that we have discussed early. Similarly, what are the features of open office calc? You people are able to remember? Yes, first one it is your. Yes, what it is? Yes, the first one it is your connecting with Excel. Next one it is your auto sum. Next one it is your list autofill. Next it is your autofill, charts, functions, and finally we finished with the database functions. You people are able to remember these features of open office calc? Yes. Now as we are going to continue with this lesson, first we are going to discuss how to create a new worksheet. So first one it is nothing but it is your creating a new worksheet. Okay, wow. So while we are discussing work, that is your writer. So we finished how to create a new writer, no? That is your document. Similar steps only we are going to discuss. Yes, before opening a new worksheet, we must know how to open office calc. So what are the steps that you people have to follow? Yes, first you have to click. Yes, start. All programs. And next what do you have to do? Yes, next you have to click open office. Next you have to click open office. Next what do you have to do? Yes, next you have to click open office calc. So when you people are clicking open office, the list of packages that are available related to open office will be displayed for you people. In that, now we are going to select open office calc. Otherwise, what you people can do? Yes, from star center. You people know what is a star center. From star center. Star center is nothing but it is your welcome screen. From this welcome screen also you people can select. What you people can select? You can select the worksheet also. So this is the way how you people can open office calc. Similarly, another one method you are having. This is your first method. And the next method, it is just by double clicking the icon that you people are having on the screen. That is your desktop. Double click open office icon. So immediately the welcome screen, that is your star center screen, will be displayed for you people. In that you people have to select open office calc. Okay, wow. So clear with the steps to open office calc. Yes, what are the steps that you people have to follow? Yes, you have to click start, all programs, open office. In that you have to select open office calc. So otherwise you people will be having a star center, that is nothing but your welcome screen. From that also you people can open office calc. Otherwise another one method you are having, that is nothing but you have to double click open office icon. So immediately star center, that is your welcome screen, will be displayed for you. From that you can select what? Open office calc. That is, you people will be having a spreadsheet icon. Just by clicking that one, the open office calc window will be opened for you. So clear with this one? So yes, after that window is opened for you, you have to open a new spreadsheet. You have to open a new spreadsheet. That is, you have to create a new spreadsheet, and the term worksheet are same for you only. Okay, wow. So for that, what step you have to follow? You have to click file, new spreadsheet. File, new spreadsheet. By clicking this one, automatically a new spreadsheet will be displayed for you. Okay, wow. Similar, what else? Now you people are able to see the spreadsheet on the desktop for you window. So this window will be more or less similar to the writer window that we have discussed early. So center part, what are the parts? Everything we are going to discuss by now. So in the center, you people will be having a one part that is called as workspace in the writer. But in this case, it is going to be called by the name worksheet. It is going to be called by the name worksheet. So worksheet will be displayed for you people. In this area only you people are going to now type type and you people are going to calculate everything are to be done in the worksheet part only. Okay, so what now you people can have a small definition for worksheet. So worksheet is nothing but it is a grid of cells with a programmable calculator attached to each cell. So what is a worksheet? Yes, it is a grid of cells. Grid means collections of cells with a programmable calculator attached to each cell. Okay, wow. So that is your worksheet. So clear with the steps how to create a new worksheet and what is the definition for worksheet? Yes, worksheet is nothing but it is a grid of cells with a programmable calculator attached to each cell. So each and every cell is going to have a programmable calculator. Okay, wow. So by default we are having three sheets. So default how many sheets will be there? Three sheets will be automatically displayed for you. So clear with the steps how to create a new worksheet? Yes, clear with the steps how to open, that is how to create a worksheet? Yes, next we are going to continue with the next topic. It is your parts of the OpenOffice Calc window. Okay, wow. We are going to discuss the parts of the window. So this window is similar to that of the writer window that we have discussed early. But here you are going to have a single difference, that is in that writer window the center part is a workspace for you people. But here it is nothing but a grid of cells. So that is your worksheet or spreadsheet. Okay, wow. Yes, we can continue with the parts of the window. Yes, when you people after opening OpenOffice Calc, you are going to have a new spreadsheet just by clicking File, New Spreadsheet. So immediately a window will be opened similar to this one. Yes, spreadsheet will be opened similar to this one. Okay, wow. Yes, what is the first part for first line for you people? First line in the title bar. Yes, you people already clear with this one, no? Yes, first it is nothing but it is your title bar. And the next one, it is your menu bar. And the next you people will be having your toolbar. So here we are having some types of toolbar. That while we are discussing the theory part, we can proceed. Okay, wow. And next here, it is your grid of cells. That is your worksheet. Yes, here you people are going to have the status bar. Okay, wow. Yes, here you people are going to have the scroll bar. Yes, so these are the parts of the OpenOffice Calc window. Yes, first we can see the first line, that is your first bar, that is nothing but it is your title bar. Yes, by the name itself you people can proceed. What is a title bar for you people? Yes, it is going to display the title of the first document, that is your first spreadsheet, that is your worksheet. So when you people are just opening that one, what will the name will be displayed there for you? Yes, the name untitled one will be displayed for you, and near that you people will be having the name of the application. So here what is the name of the application? The name of the application is OpenOffice Calc. So in the title bar you will be having untitled one, immediately you will be having OpenOffice Calc. So that will be displayed on the title bar for you. So this title bar, what it is telling you? Yes, it is telling the title of the document, that is your title of the spreadsheet that you people have opened. So if after performing needed calculation steps, if you people are going to save your spreadsheet, means what it will be happening? The name that you have given will be replaced by title, that is your untitled one. So for example, if you people are going to save this spreadsheet by the name sample, so in the title bar what you people will be having? Yes, you will be having sample. Then what do you be having? Yes, name of the application, that is nothing but OpenOffice Calc you will be having. So clear with the title bar. So in the title bar itself, to the right end, you people will be having a control buttons. You people will be having control buttons. So what are the control buttons? Yes, the control buttons are nothing but it is your minimize. Next one, it is your maximize. And next, it is your close button. So these are the three buttons, control buttons that are seen in the right corner for you. So minimize cut button, what it is going to do? Just by clicking that one, the whole spreadsheet will be minimized to the task bar for you. And next, you people are having the maximize button. Otherwise, it is your restore button. Okay, wow. Maximize, it is going to make the screen that is somewhat big for you people. Restore, if it is to fit the screen will be enlarged for you. Next, it is your close. You can close this current document that you people are working, or you people can close the whole application. So that is your close buttons. Okay, ma'am. So these are the three buttons that are available in the right corner of the title bar. So clear with this one? Yes. Next, we can have the next one. It is your menu bar. Next, you people are going to have the next, it is your menu bar. So here below the title bar, we are having the menu bar. So here, what are the menus that are available or more or less similar to that of the OpenOffice Writer that we have already discussed. Okay, wow. So under the menu bar, first you people are going to have the first one, it is your file. So next, we are going to discuss what are the menus that are available in menu bar. Okay, wow. In that, the first one, it is your file. By the name itself, you people can have. The file menu is going to have all the file management tasks. So it is going to have the commands. So the commands that are related to file management task. Okay, wow. To file management task. So what are the file management tasks? Yes, it can be you are creating a file, creating a new file, opening already existing file, save a spreadsheet or save as a spreadsheet, or close then print. Oh yes, these are the few file management tasks that you people are having. Okay, wow. Yes, next it is your edit menu. Yes, next one, it is your edit. Okay, wow. So first we finish the file menu. Next, it is your edit menu. So under the edit menu, what commands you people are going to have? Yes, you are going to have cut, copy, paste. Yes, what are the formatting? Everything will be available under edit for you people. Next one, it is your view. Yes, under the view menu, what do you people are going to have? Yes, by the name itself. Now you people are going to view something. That is, by means of this one, you people can modify this environment. Modify. What else modification that you people are going to do or willing to do? Everything. For that, what are the commands that are needed? Everything are available under this view menu bar. Okay, wow. And the next one, it is your insert. Insert means, yes, if you people are going to insert few, it's your spreadsheet, no? If you are going to insert some cells, some column, or what else, row, everything you people can insert. So these and all available under which menu for you? Insert menu, okay, wow. And the next one, it is your format. What do you mean by format? Yes, this is going to have the formatting features. What are the formatting features? Simple formatting features that you people know are bold, italic, that and all. So that features are available under this format menu for you. Okay, wow. And the next one, it is your tool. And next one, it is your tools. So what this menu is going to contain? Yes, it is going to contain few things for your spell check. For your spell check. And next, to protect the document, insert pictures. Everything are seen under which menu for you? Tools menu. And next one, it is your data. Yes, and this is going to contain the commands that are needed to manipulate the data. So manipulation, what else? Manipulation means calculation. Okay, wow. That you people are willing to do. Everything that commands are available under this data menu only. So what are the commands you people can have? Yes, you can have sort. Sort means what? Yes, whether you are going to arrange them in ascending order or descending order, that is your sorting. Next, it is your filter, total validity, everything you people can do. Okay, well, that commands are available under which menu for you? Data menu. And next, you people are having the window. What this window is going to do? Yes, by means of this, you people can have a new window. Next, you people can split the window. Yes, you people can freeze the window. Yes, everything can be done by the commands that are available under this window menu. And last, you people are going to have the next one. It is your help. By means of this, you people can have the inbuilt help features available in OpenOffice. Inbuilt. So here all the helping features are already inbuilt for you people. Okay, wa? Just by clicking that needed name, you people can have the help that are related to the needed topics. Okay, wa? So these are the menus that are available under menu bar. So first one, it is your file. File is going to have what and all? Open, close, create, okay, wow, etc. These and all you will be having. Under edit, you people are going to have cut, copy, paste options. For view, to modify the environment, few commands are available there. And under insert menu, you are going to have the cell insert, column, row, what else, insertion that you people are willing to do. Yes, you people can do by means of this menu. And next one, it is your format. You people can perform the formatting. And next, it is your tools. Under tools, we are going to have the spell check. Then next it is, you people can insert pictures, images, everything by means of this tools. And next it is your data. Under the data, what else? Manipulation that you people are willing to do by the data that are available on the spreadsheet. For that, we are having the commands under the data menu. Few two example are sort, filter. And next it can be your validity, subtotal. These are the few examples that are few example commands that are available under data for you. And the next one, it is your window. By means of this window, what do you people, by means of this menu, what do you people can do? You people can split it, you can have a new window, you can freeze that window. And last, you people are going to have the help in the menu bar. So it help is nothing but it is a inbuilt function, inbuilt help function that is available. Just by clicking that one, you people can have the help for the needed topic. So clear with the menus that are available under menu bar. Yes, next we are going to have the next bar. It is your toolbar. Okay, va? So where the toolbar is seen for you people? Yes, it is seen here. You are having, no, it is seen next to the menu bar. Menu bar is seen next to the title bar. Then next to toolbar is seen next to the menu bar for you people. By the name itself, here you people are toolbar means, yes, it is going to have some collection of tools for you. So here the toolbar is of three types. The first one, it is your standard toolbar. First one, it is your standard. Yes, by means of standard means what and all it is going to have? Yet it is going to have the frequently used commands. So here the tools that are available in the standard toolbar are nothing but the commands that you people are going to use frequently. So what else you people will be using frequently? Yes, you can have edit. Sorry, you people can have open. So what else available under the edit menu, file menu you will be having? So under the edit menu, file menu, you will be having open, close, print, preview and all. For that also tools you people will be having. Similarly under edit you will be having cut, copy, paste. So that and all will be seen under the standard toolbar. Okay, wow. Similarly for sorting, inserting, chart, send, save, everything you will be having under the standard toolbar. And next you people are going to have the second one. It is your formatting toolbar. What do you mean by formatting? Yes, it is going to contain the text and cell formatting commands. For what purpose? Yes, for changing the font style. For changing font style, size, color, font color, okay, wow. Then the alignment, cell formatting, etc. These are the few to tell. Cell formatting. Yes, these are the few four more few only told here for you people. Few are first one. You people can have the font style. That is, you will be having to have to select the Times New Roman or what else font. Arial Black or what else that are available from that collection, inbuilt font style, you people can select the needed one. Based upon that one, the style will be applied on the spreadsheet, okay, va? Then the font size, font color, alignment, cell formatting, for each and everything, what are the tools that you people can use, everything are seen in the formatting toolbar. And the next one, it is nothing but it is your formula bar, okay, va? So totally how many types of toolbars we are having in OpenOffice Calc? The first one, it is your standard toolbar, next one, it is your formatting toolbar, and the next one, it is your formula bar. Yes, formula bar. So third one, it is your formula bar. So you people know why we are in need of spreadsheet. Yes, just for the calculation purpose only we are in need of spreadsheet. So here, for you must have a separate bar to perform the calculation. So that is your third toolbar, that is your formula bar, okay va? So it is an important element in the spreadsheet. Without this formula bar, it is quite impossible for you people to perform the calculation. So this formula bar is going to contain five important buttons for you, okay, so five important functions, simple to say five important buttons you people are going to have under this formula bar. The first one, it is your name box. The first one, it is your name box. Yes, we can have the formula bar here, okay, va? Yes, I am drawing this one. No, this is your simple representation of formula bar. Fx, this is your summation equal to, next it is your input. Yes, we can continue with our discussion, okay, va? So this first one, it is your name box. Name box is nothing but it is going to have the address of the cell. Each and everything we can discuss by now, okay, va? It is going to display the current cell address. It is going to display the current cell address. Which is going to display the current cell address? Yes, the name box is going to display the current cell address. Okay, va? And the next two people are having the next one. It is your function wizard. What do you mean by wizard? Simple to say, you people will be having a collection. Okay, va? So this is your function wizard. So mainly the spreadsheet is used for the purpose of calculations only. So here this function wizard is going to have a collections of functions for you. Just by clicking that one, you people can use that functions that are available in OpenOffice Calc, okay, va? So it is used to insert function. It is used to insert function. Yes, and the next one, it is your sum button. Sum means just to perform the addition. Just by clicking this one, you people can have your total. Addition total can be done by this one. To insert the sum button quickly. Insert sum button quickly we are having here. And next you people are having the next one. It is your function button equal to we are having, no? So that is your function button. So each and every function, that is each and every equations or each and every calculation must begin with this equal to symbol only. Okay, va? And next you people are going to have the next one. It is your input line. It is your input line. So this is your input line. So what is the input line is going to do? Yes, it is going to show the contents of the current cell. It is going to show the contents of current cell means, which is the current cell for you by now? A1, okay, va? It is going to show the contents of current cell. So it will always show exactly what you typed in the cell. It is also used to edit the content. So in this area, you people can have your formulas, everything. Similarly, what else they edit? Edit means what? Changes, if you people are willing to do, means everything must be done in which area for you people? Everything must be done in the input line for you. Okay, va? So clear with this one. So clear with the third bar. that is your formula bar. Okay, so totally how many toolbars you people are having? So totally 3 toolbars we are having. That is your standard toolbar, formatting toolbar, and the next one, it is your formula bar. So clear with the formula bar that we have discussed by now. So clear with the topics, what else we have discussed by today? So today we are in which topic? Yes, we are in parts of the window. In that, first we finished, yes, you people know the step to how to open this spreadsheet. What is the step that you have to follow? Yes, start, all programs, open office, open office scal. Then you people have to open a new worksheet, that is your new spreadsheet. Means what do you people have to do? You have to click file, then you have to click new, then you have to click spreadsheet. So immediately a spreadsheet resembling to this one will be opened for you. Yes, next we are discussing the parts of the window. In that, first we finish the title bar. Okay, wow. Next we finished the control buttons. And next we finished the menu bar. So under the menu bar, what are the menus that we have discussed? Yes, first one, it is your file. Next one, it is your edit. Next one, it is your view. Insert. Format. Tools. Data. Window. And the last one we finished, it is your help. So these are the menus that we have discussed under the menu bar. Similarly, in the control buttons, we have discussed minimize, maximize, and the next one, it is your close. Okay, wow. And the next, you people are going to have the, it is your tools bar. Here it is of three types. What are the three types? The first one, it is your standard toolbar. And the next one, it is your formatting toolbar. And the next one, it is your formula bar. Okay, wow. So under this formula bar, we are having few. That is the first one, it is your name box. And the next one, it is your function wizard. And the next one, it is your sum button. And the last one we finished, it is your input line. So these are the topics that we have discussed by today. So clear with the parts of the window, few part we have discussed in the parts of the window. So clear with the topic that we have discussed by today. Yes, students, remaining we can continue in the next class. Yes, thank you, students.